Morning, Ross.
Morning, sir.
Thanks much.
Oh, Mr. Donner?
Huh?
I'm starting to sell subscriptions to the Saturday Evening Post. Can I put you down for one?
I'm not much for magazines.
How about if I give you the first month free? And a week's free newspapers?
Ross Johnson, you could sell ice to an Eskimo.
I'd sure give it a try. Thank you, sir.
Mrs. Vitelliano? F. Ross Johnson, Peerless Child Photographers.
No thanks.
Even if you don't want any pictures, I gotta tell you, I see babies all day long, but that is one exceptionally beautiful child. Can I ask her name?
Marvin.
What can I tell you? He's pretty enough to be a girl. You know, that being the case, I'm gonna offer you, give you is more like it. A set of six pictures and an ordinarily $5 walnut frame offer just the one price of $2.98. Tell your mom you want your picture taken, Marvin. Well, there you go. You heard it from his own lips.
Oh, well.
Ed Horrigan there. Tell him it's Ross Johnson. Ed, can you hear me? It's Ross. Did you get the tape yet? Ah, great. I'll tell you when. Make sure somebody keeps the senator's glass full. We'll be there in a jiff. Not bad for a newspaper boy from Winnipeg, eh?
Not bad at all.
What do you think? You want to fly to Palm Springs when this is over, or you want to wait and go in the morning?
In the morning. Wouldn't mind getting an hour's sleep.
You're getting old.
One of us has to.
Here's Ross!
Johnny,
Ross.
Ben,
how
nice to see you, here.
Yeah.
Have I got a great joke for you, Ed? Well, I hope you'll like it as much after you've heard it. Seems this lady got stung by a bee on the golf course. Any of you guys heard this?
No, go ahead, Ross.
Yeah, all right. Well, anyway, she gets stung by this bee. She goes to the doctor, and the doctor says, just exactly where did it bite you? And she says, between the first and second hole. And he said, no kidding, you must have a pretty wide stance.
All set with the tape, Ross.
Oh, great,
great. This crowd is going to go bananas. Honey, honey, go rescue the mayor. His wife's starting to talk to him.
Poor John.
How are you, Laurie?
Your face gets any longer, I can practice putting on it.
Come on, Ed. You leave my boy alone.
It's just this kind of spending is crazy, Ross.
Oh, John, the company's making so much money, we're shitting green. Hell, this all comes out of petty cash. Showtime.
Listen up, everybody. Could I have everyone's attention here, please? I want to extend a warm welcome to everyone here tonight on behalf of RJR Nabisco, from our chairman, Charlie Hugo. Yeah. Ed Horrigan, president of our tobacco division. And if you think his numbers are good now, just wait until people start buying Premier. And, of course, Johnny Grinnis, president of Nabisco. From each and every one of us, all the way down to me. Now, as soon as these guys up here take care of business, I'm going to have a little extra treat for you in case anybody missed the 6 o'clock news or might have spent the day on Uranus. But no matter how this little Donnybrook turns out, we're all winners here tonight. Right, Ed?
Right to that.
Out your stock going up. And have a great time. There's plenty of booze, and if you don't think so, you're just not trying hard enough. So enjoy the fight. Thank you. Good fight, huh?
Come on, stick it.
Enjoy it.
Various opponents have complained that Tyson rocks the ring goes along the ropes getting close.
Fight, huh?
See the technician?
Some kind of fight, ain't it?
And Pacino already warning Mike about the elbow.
Primary Governor Dukakis appears headed for certain victory to head the Democratic ticket come November. While in the New Jersey federal court today, it was a victory of sorts for widower Anthony Cipollone. Cipollone had sued for millions, claiming cigarettes were a contributing factor in the death of his wife, a lifelong smoker. Tobacco companies breathed a sigh of relief when today's jury cleared the industry of any responsibility and awarded the widower the relatively small amount of $400,000 in damages.
A tip for Tony Cipollone. Shit, the fucking stock hasn't budged, Ed. Not one fucking point. I thought the Cipollone decision would pump a little sunshine up our skirts. We're still stuck in the fucking 40s. Thanks, Bobby.
Any fucking time.
I mean, everybody's picking it up. Did you see the hatchet job in Business Week? RJR low stock price, tobacco company declining performance, executive extravagance. I love this. CEO F. Ross Johnson routinely presses $50 bills into the hands of wine stewards.
I saw that.
$50 bills. Jesus, it's been years since I tipped that little.
Hey, you let them bitch all they want about the stock, Ross. Wait till Premier's hit the market.
Yeah, where are we on the test results?
Oh, week. 10 days the latest. They're gonna be great, trust me.
They damn well better be. Put a rocket up Winston-Salem's ass, will you? So we get them ASAP, okay?
You got it.
I'll see you in the Springs, Bart.
All right.
Well, hi there, cutie.
How you doing, pal?
What'd you do? Did you sneak up here from Coach?
You don't mind, do you, mister? I just can't keep my feet off of you.
Easy, Laura. Not in front of DOG.
See all of you out here tomorrow when the tournament begins. Huh? We're going to have a great time.
Well, you'll do a good job for us. Well, having fun, John? You look like death on a biscuit.
Well, I'm not
Ross,
convinced at all.
Great party last night.
What'd you know?
I must have really been wasted. I didn't realize these watches you were giving out were Gucci's.
You fly Nabisco, you go first class. You have a good one, Jay. John, forget what all this cost. This bunch this weekend. How many supermarkets do you think they own between? What, 8,000, 9,000? Well, every time one of these guys gets home and he shows off his Gucci and his free Polaroid and his picture with Arnie or Reggie, whose merchandise do you think he's going to put on his shelves? Oh, lighten up, John boy. Every penny you think I'm pissing away here comes back to us dressed up like a nickel. Don, Ira, let's go. Let's tee it up.
Terrific turnout, Ross. You do it better every year.
Thanks, Ira.
Will we talk for a second? Just for a second? My shareholders are getting antsy as hell about the price of their RJR stock. I mean, the way it's just laying there.
Tell them to stop breathing down my shorts, okay? As soon as we introduce Premier's, the damn stock's going to go through the roof. Ed tells me that the test results are going to be dynamite.
Well, that'll sure help take some of the pressure off. All we want you to do is make us as rich as possible, Russ. That's all we're asking.
Or you'll find somebody else who will, right?
And there's one sure way you might want to look into. It's worked well for other companies.
Screw those LBOs, if that's what you're talking about.
You know how much money Don made on his? You telling me you wouldn't want a $400 million payday? $400 million, Ross.
Yeah, Lyra, they can only bury you with one set of golf clubs.
Yeah. There's no question that he could do for you what he did for me. I know he'd be delighted to work with you.
Why Henry Kravitz?
Because Henry's the best. He was the first to do a company buyout. He practically owns the patent on the process.
What kind of fee does he get? What was his cut for setting up your deal?
1%. $45 million.
1% sure has come up in the world, hasn't it?
On a Safeway buyout, he and his cousin George pocketed 60. $60 million apiece.
Those guys aren't careful. They're going to get seriously rich.
They can do the same thing for you, Ross.
And the stockholders.
Yes!
Next time you're in New York, why don't I set up dinner with him? I know you hit it off.
No offense, Don, but we're talking about buying out RJR Nabisco here. We're talking Astrobucks.
Well, how astro are you thinking? Henry has the ability to borrow as much as $56 billion.
Makes your $400 million seem a little like pin money, doesn't it?
Well, every little bit helps, Ross. Every little bit helps.
How'd we you?
Well, we each owe Don $3.
Yeah, I hope this puts the son of a bitch in the higher tax bracket.
Good evening, sir. Right in there. Come, Christy.
Thank you.
Christy.
Ross.
Don, it's nice to see you again.
It's good to see you.
Will you have a drink, sir?
Scotch and soda. No ice, no soda.
Thank you, sir.
Be it ever so humble, huh?
The guy must have had a hell of a week.
Renoir.
Ballpark?
20, 30 million.
Is that with the frame?
Monet.
Yeah, right. Tons of it.
Doc?
Henry, say hello to Ross Johnson.
Ross, nice of you to come.
Well, listen, Henry, if there's anything you need, if you're hurting in any way at all you have to do is ask. The thing is, it looks like a normal cigarette, only when you light up a Premier, it's completely smokeless.
Totally?
Near enough. The point is that it produces absolutely no tar or any of that other fun cancer stuff.
If you sell it as a safer cigarette, aren't you admitting your other brands are unsafe?
It is safer. Of course, we can't say that. But, Bryce, you get more carbon monoxide from a New York bus going by than you can from any cigarette. Maybe just a little more chicken.
It's rabbit.
Oh, I'll have the ears, too, when you get a chance.
You're counting on Premier's getting your stock up, obviously. Nothing else has made it move.
It's a bitch. I've got the best company in the world. And not just because I'm in charge. You could put your crazy old aunt in and she could run Nabisco. You know, our food assets are unbelievable. Kids pop out of the womb asking for Oreos, and it doesn't make one damn bit of difference in the price of our shares. People still think of us as only a tobacco company. They're so scared we're going to get sued out of existence, it just murders us.
There is a cure for that.
Oh, that LBO stuff's way over my head, Henry. I just can't follow it.
You don't have to. Bankers and lawyers work it all out.
Well, all I want from bankers is a new calendar every year, and all I care about lawyers is they're back in their coffins before the sun comes up.
Everyone benefits when management takes over. It's simply a question of arriving at an attractive price to pay your stockholders to buy out their shares. I'd work with you the same way we did with Don. Some of the money we borrow. Some we raise from the public sale of securities. We pay off the debt incurred in buying the company with cash from its ongoing operation and by selling off pieces of the business.
That's French for firing people, isn't it, Henry?
As few as possible, of course.
A few dozen, 10,000?
As I said, as few as possible.
I couldn't do that. I couldn't live with the fallout.
I'd take care of that.
You know, I don't shave your face in my mirror every morning. All that aside, I've never been a big fan of debt.
Debt can be an asset. Debt tightens a company.
Does wonders for the sphincter, too.
Why don't I have some of my people take a look at your numbers? Get an idea of the value of the company. Something to base a bid on.
Well, tell me one thing. If we did do this thing together, who'd be in charge? Who'd run the business? How does that work?
Ask Don.
I run my company. Henry and his cousin George are the majority owners, but they maintain a total hands-off policy.
What's the catch?
The catch is we like people who know what they're doing. Doing it for us. We think you're one of those people, Ross.
I like smoke, damn it.
Ten percentage points, when just 2 weeks ago, Dukakis was ahead by 17. In New York, further shockwaves hit the financial world as investigators reveal that junk bond specialist Michael Milken, whose earnings this year topped the $500 million mark, and 26 other members of Milken's investment firm of Drexel Burnham Lombard were owners of a stake in the company owned by dethroned financial wizard Ivan Boesky. Boesky, convicted on charges of insider trading, was recently sentenced to 18 months in jail and fined a record $100 million.
You know the three rules of Wall Street? Never play by the rules, never tell the truth, and never pay in cash. They earn their money the old-fashioned way. They steal it.
Ross, you promise you won't think I'm stupid?
Of course not, although I have been known to break my promises.
There's just so much about this I don't get. Insider trading, junk bonds, even this buyout thing you're talking about.
Sweetheart, half the people involved don't know what's going on. Buyouts aren't all that hard, really. Basically, all a buyout means is that management, the team that runs the company, they buy out all the shareholders, and the company goes from being public to being private.
Doesn't that take a ton of money?
That's where the Kravis types come in. They help you borrow what you need against the assets of the company, and they use the business as collateral.
So it's just like mortgaging a house.
I hate to tell you this, babe, but you've got a lot to learn about being stupid. Now, the problem is, you get guys like Henry as your partner, and they're 2 miles up your ass with a power tool making sure you do things their way. You've got to see that apartment. It makes Buckingham Palace look like a Burger King. Nobody gets that rich letting anyone play co-god with him.
How are you going to handle that?
Nothing to handle. There's no way I'd hook up with Henry Kravis. Now, if we ever made a deal, he'd have my desk in the men's room in 5 seconds flat. All we have to do is just stay cool until Ed gets the test results on Premier's. You watch. You just watch. Those babies are going to turn the whole company around.
Now, of all the people we interviewed, 86% approved of the idea of a smokeless cigarette. And 41% said that they'd be willing to try at least 2 packs before deciding whether or not to switch brands. Of those who had given up cigarettes, 73% responded favorably to the idea, saying that they would seriously consider smoking again if they could be positive that the cigarette that they were smoking was absolutely smokeless. Now, 8% of that group sampled at least one Premier to give us their opinion of the product.
Bottom line?
Well, of all the groups we tested, the response to Premier was just about uniform.
They all said they tasted like shit.
Like shit?
Shit was the consensus, yes, sir.
They all said that? Nobody liked them?
Fewer than 5%.
You said you heard the results were terrific.
Well, there's nothing wrong with 5%, Ross. I'll take 5% of the smoking market any day of the week.
How much are we in for up to now?
To date?
To date, to here, to now.
Upwards of 350.
We've spent $350 million and we've come up with a turd with a tip? God almighty, Ed. We poured enough technology into this project to send a cigarette to the moon and we come up with one that tastes like it took a dump?
We haven't even talked about the smell.
Well, what'd they say that was like? A fart?
Yeah.
Oh, you're not serious. They really said that?
We've got an awful lot of fart figures, sir, yes.
Tastes like shit and smells like a fart. We got ourselves a real winner here. It's one goddamn unique advertising slogan, I'll give you that. $350 million?
What the hell's wrong with that? I don't smell anything.
That's not the way to find out, sir. You see, if you light a Premier with a match instead of a lighter, the sulfur reacts badly with the carbon in the tip.
Do we have to have the carbon?
Well, that's what makes it smokeless.
Well, how do we get it shitless?
But that's hard to say. I mean, given enough time,
we don't have any time. We've announced they're coming out this year. You insisted on it.
Because you did.
Because you said they'd be ready.
Well, they are ready.
They just need a few adjustments.
God almighty, Ed, I don't have to tell you what's writing on these goddamn things. And what the hell's wrong with the draw? You need an extra set of lungs just to take a draft.
It is a little difficult.
A little difficult?
It's what we call the hernia effect.
Is that what we call it? Well, there's another great billboard for you. What do? We give away a truss with every pack? Warning, this cigarette can tear your balls off.
But they're not so bad.
Stop jerking off, Ed. Who the hell would sneak into a John to smoke one of these? Wherever you light one up, you're in the shit house. And I'm beginning to get the same feeling myself.
How do we break it to the board? Some of them can't wait for you to make a slip like this, you know that. They just love to nail your nuts to your forehead.
Don't sweat it. I just may have something more important than premieres to tell them.
You got something up your sleeve?
I'm gonna buy the company.
You're not serious.
Watch me. Get my wife at Palm Beach. Try Elizabeth Arden's. Tell her to pack for New York. No, never mind. Call the plane. Tell them instead of Chicago, we'll pick up Mrs. Johnson in Florida. Then would you get Jim Robinson at American Express? No. Try his apartment in New York. Mrs. Johnson, please. Mr. Johnson. Also, Charlie Hugel in Seoul at the Chosen Hotel. March has a number in Atlanta.
You sure, Ross? It's that bad?
Trust me, okay? We huffed and we puffed. We came up with a filtered Edsel. If I could, I'd burn every last one of them, except you can't even set fire to the fuckers.
So you are going to buy the company, is that what you're saying?
It isn't the premieres, Laura. I got no other choice. The stock just won't budge.
Even though you're sure he'll take over?
What are you talking about?
The company, Henry Kravis.
Who said anything about Henry Kravis?
Robinson's residence.
Jim. Is this a bad time?
No, just dressing. Going to a charity do. What's happened?
Rats.
Are you serious? That is one tremendous step, Ross. Really tremendous. But tomorrow's fine. Absolutely. Now, come ahead. Now, we'll be in Connecticut the whole weekend. This is terribly exciting. I can't tell you how pleased I am that you thought to call me first.
Oh, this is impossible. I give up.
Kiss your good lady for me. I certainly will.
Never do this again. I feel ridiculous.
Linda, better move it, sweetie.
2 seconds, Jim. God, my third can of hairspray.
That was Ross. He's got a little project he wants some help with.
Oh?
He wants to buy out RJR Nabisco.
What?
A low stock price is not the end of the world, Ross. I mean, buying the company is like shooting your arm off to get rid of a hangnail.
Jim's not about to steer me wrong on this, Charlie. Not as a friend and not as chairman of American Express. With their controlling interest in Shearson, he's going to be looking over their shoulder the whole time. Are you okay? I can hardly hear you.
I said,
There's no way you can pull this off without putting the company deep into debt. Now, are you ready to cut back on all the perks? All the planes, the apartment in New York, the house in Palm Beach? You really want to turn your life around?
I'm not doing this to become a homeless person, Charlie, or planeless either. Look, just leave all this to me. Try to have some fun over there. Get out of your room. Go enjoy Korea.
Are you sure you can't come by? I'd love to show you my new sketches.
I can't, Caroline, really.
Jim, are they there? Okay, 2 minutes, I'm on my way. Gotta run, big business.
Even God rested on Sunday, Linda.
She didn't make my salary. Kiss Henry for me. Nothing like being late to your own house.
Good ride?
Great, only got 2 coals.
What you need is an unlisted horse.
Shall we? Laurie, why don't you sit there, Ross?
Lovely, as usual.
Thank you.
Thanks, dear. Oh, I think Henry's taken out a contract on the sky. Henry?
Kravis, just down the road.
Big hunter, our Henry. Okay. Tell me.
Well, Ross has agreed to let Shearson Lehman raise all the money he needs for the buyout.
Oh, Ross, that is so super.
It just seems right. You guys are like family.
Did you call Peter?
I will call into him now.
Peter?
Yeah, Peter Cohen. He runs Shearson for Jim.
He is chomping at the bit to pull off a deal like this one. I mean, Peter is ready.
Are you saying he's never done a buyout before?
No, he's done one. Nothing this big, but the procedure's the same. I mean, first, you lay out the terms that you're looking for yourself in all this. And then you make the company's records available. Peter and his people go to work and come up with a proper bid for you to make. I mean, he can outline the whole deal probably when you're down in Palm Beach.
Can he do it in 3 weeks? I'd love to spring this at the next board meeting.
Don't see why not.
Ross... Could I pitch my firm to handle the PR for you, or am I being too piggy?
I was saving that for dessert.
Hello? Peter.
Hi.
Cancel your life for the next couple of weeks, fella. You've got a lot of work ahead of you. Yeah, hold on.
It's all gonna happen that fast? It has to happen fast. Fast and quiet. Confidentiality is critical. If this hits the press, you'll have a feeding frenzy on your hand. One word gets out about this company being for sale, and everybody and his brother's going to try and buy it.
Or everybody and his cousin.
Gonna give you the broad strokes, okay? The whole deal, the actual document, is taller than my son. Tom?
RJR Nabisco's shares are trading presently at 53 1/8. The highest they have ever been was in the neighborhood of 71.
Which is where they really belong.
Our proposal is, come Wednesday's board meeting, you make an offer to buy the company at $75 a share.
75? Jesus, that sounds high.
It is high. That's the idea.
It's gotta be attractive as hell.
And still make sense to us, of course.
Well... how much would that come to? At 75 a share, how much would we need to raise?
We'll be looking for $17 billion.
That's one piss load of money.
Exactly. We'll be throwing the kind of numbers at the board that no one else possibly can.
In one shot, we're knocking out any and all conceivable competition.
But at that price, with that kind of debt load, how long is it going to be before your bean counters start trying to pare down the company expenses, telling me how many jets I can have and all that nickel-nursing crap?
Never. You run the company the way you want.
You're talking total control?
Absolutely.
We'd never expose our investors to that much risk if we didn't think your expertise wasn't going to get it all back for them.
I'd have to borrow an extra ass to work off to do it, I can tell you that.
Using the requirements which you gave us as the basis for your deal, this is what you personally stand to make over the next 5 years once you take over RJR Nabisco.
Are these figures for real?
It'd be even more.
It's awfully rich, Ross, and it makes the deal much more difficult. I'm sure you wouldn't want to advertise those numbers to anyone, of course.
I don't think a skywriter would have enough smoke for them all, do you?
You're going to do extremely well. Especially when these guys come out, right? May I?
Huh.
What is that taste? What is that taste? What does this taste like?
We're working on it. I hope you didn't pack too much, honey. We'll only be in Atlanta for the board meeting. Laura, what's the matter?
I think it stinks. Did you know people in the company were calling me Cupcake behind my back?
I'm fixing them, babe. I'm working on a deal in Florida to get you an honorary degree.
Honest to God.
Bet your ass. From now on, they're going to have to start calling you Dr. Cupcake.
Oh, you think he's coming down with something? Poor Rocco, you all right?
RJ1 passenger, Mr. G. Shepherd, is on board. We're ready to roll.
RJ1 cleared for takeoff. Give our best to Mr. Shepherd.
Poor baby. You'll be a lot happier back in Florida.
Jim, heart of hearts, bottom line, you really think Peter can pull this off? Something this big?
Oh, I figure we'll be okay. With my head on his shoulders, your head on mine. If I didn't think so, I wouldn't be this relaxed.
You worried?
Worried? That I'm gonna pull off the biggest deal in history? That it's gonna kill Henry Kravis to find out that everybody else on the street isn't just shit? Shit.
What's wrong?
I just realized what they taste like.
What are you thinking?
What am I thinking? I'm thinking my lapels are too wide, my hair is too long, I was born with the wrong fork in my mouth. But if all goes well tomorrow, this paper boy from Winnipeg is going to own the 19th largest corporation in America.
If I'm lucky, do I get to kiss your ring?
Well, that's as good a place to start as any.
Mr. Grennis is here.
Johnny! Well, Johnny, what do you think?
They arrived just as I was leaving. It's an awful lot to take in.
That could wait now. I got something really important to tell you.
Well, more important than proposing that we sink $2.5 billion into expanding our bakeries.
Cookieville. That's a great name, Ross. Great name.
It's also wasteful. It's completely unnecessary. A $10 million computer to bring the onion bits to the mixing dough when all you really need is one guy with a forklift.
I'm gonna let you boys work this one out. Good luck later, Ross. My money's on you.
Thank you, Ed. Now, just cool it a minute, Johnny. Can I get you a drink? You
want anything? I'm fine. I'm good.
Good is cotton stockings next to great, John. I'm going to make you rich.
Well, you already have, Ross.
No, you just think you are. All that changes today. Sit down, partner. Come on, sit down. Are you ready?
Yeah.
I'm going to buy out the company.
I had no idea.
Going to wrap it up in a week. 10 days at the most.
And you're doing this with just Ed and three others from management?
Right.
Why not everybody? Why didn't you include all of us?
John, if this deal goes through, the debt load just might force a few divisions to go on the block. Now, obviously, I can't have partners owning the company with me who aren't even going to be with the company, can I?
You're not going to sell off Nabisco.
Well, I'd rather not if I don't have to.
My God, Ross, how can you do this? In one breath, you're talking about expanding the company, and then in the next one, you're talking about ditching it.
Whatever happens, you're safe, John. I mean, after the incredible way you've run the food division, there's no question about whoever buys it's going to keep you on. Hey, if you're not happy with the new brass, with your severance deal plus your, what, 50,000 shares in Nabisco, you could walk away with $7 million, maybe more. We're not talking just fuck you money, John boy. We're talking fuck everybody money.
Fuck everybody. Right, Ross. Fuck everybody.
Wish me luck?
I just pray you get it. I really do.
Well, thank you, John. I appreciate that. Mr. Chairman, members of the board, I don't have to tell anyone here that RJR Nabisco has remained wildly undervalued. Despite our steady yearly profits, despite your management's best efforts to increase shareholder values. Now, after a great deal of study, after exploring every conceivable option, we feel that the best possible way, the only way, to recognize those values is through a leveraged buyout.
Well, that's awfully radical, isn't it, Ross? The wolf isn't exactly at the door around.
I'm not pushing the panic button, Vernon. I'm simply offering it as the one option that best looks after our shareholders.
You don't think the shares will get a big boost once we start selling premiums?
Oh, they're still a crapshoot. I'm talking about a bird in the hand. I'm talking about putting a mountain of money into everybody's pocket right now.
You believe what you have in mind is doable?
Absolutely. And at a figure much higher than the stock is selling for today.
What stage are you at? How far along is this gone?
I can only tell you that if the board gives us a green light, we would be in a position to wrap it up very quickly, I'd say, in a matter of days.
Well, we'd want to be sure the number you're thinking about is not frivolous.
You'll have to define frivolous for me, Mr. Chairman.
Well, I'd say your offer has to be north of the highest price this company's ever traded at.
Would you say that $75 a share meets that geographic requirement?
Well, I suggest you and your group leave the room, Ross, so the board can discuss your proposal.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Thank you all, and happy reading.
That was a good job, buddy.
Keep everything crossed.
Oh, it was a perfect pitch, Ross. Perfect. You're not nervous, are you?
Hell no. I always take a leak with my flight closed.
The LBO, according to the company's official release, would be the largest takeover in corporate history. In a surprise move, the company's chief executive officer, F. Ross Johnson, today offered his stockholders $17.6 billion for their shares of RJR Nabisco, suppliers of such famous products as Oreos, Camels, Winston's, and Salem's. $17 billion. Now that's cigarette money.
Charlie threw me a real curve putting out that goddamn press release so fast. I mean, how the hell could Peter Cohen not have anticipated it? $17 billion, for Christ's sake. It's like trying to sweep a ton of elephant shit under the carpet. Can't believe we're off to this kind of start.
Have you talked to Jim?
You're damn right I have. His ass is on the line, too. If Shearson blows this, he has his own board to answer to.
Oh, my God.
What?
Is your TV on?
Senator, you're no Jack Kennedy.
Which channel?
The Four.
That was really uncalled for, Senator.
As I said earlier, we are at
Holy
the corporate
shit.
Headquarters of RJR Nabisco. The all-important board meeting is happening right now as we circle the building.
Thank you.
have a share.
Do you believe the gall?
He's trying to steal the company. They're going for a slam dunk.
He's trying to pull it off before anyone else can come up with another bid.
I was the one who gave Johnson the idea for a buyout in the first place. Laid it all out for him. I mean, there has to be some minimal appreciation on the man's part for how the system works. Some respect for the rules.
First time in the jungle, I guess.
Well, I'm not giving him any points for innocence. He got the art of the double cross down real fast. And of all the people in the world, why Peter Cohen? Shearson has no real experience with leveraged buyouts. Sure as hell don't start with the biggest one ever. It's because of Jim, you figure?
Word is, Johnson's hired Linda to do his PR.
Is that a fact or just a rumor?
Rumor's just a premature fact, Henry.
Linda.
It just doesn't make sense. You didn't sew up the deal before you disclosed it. I mean, why'd you leave us all so vulnerable?
Isn't anybody listening? I didn't disclose it. Charlie Hugel sprung that press release
Ross
all on his own.
I think you should have anticipated it, and frankly, so do I.
No offense, but I'm not running the PR on this deal, am I?
Charlie is advertising. He's fishing, hoping somebody will come in and top Ross's offer.
Never. Nobody else is going to step up with a higher number. Nobody else has the muscle.
Nobody but Henry.
He'd never give Ross what we have. You got a picture of Henry allowing Ross total control of the company? Trust me, in a week, this is a done deal.
Mrs. Robinson on line two.
Linda.
Henry.
You just floored us with this RJR thing. Are you aware that we gave that idea to Johnson in the first place? Now, we're not going to sit this one out on the sidelines. You understand that?
I do, Henry.
I want you to make that very clear to everyone, and I want to hear back soonest.
He's pissed.
Tough.
He said he's not going to sit on the sidelines.
He only has to sit there a few more days.
He said he's the one that gave Ross the idea for the leverage
and
buyout.
And Ross decided to go with us, so?
LBOs are his game, Peter. He invented them. And it's clear he doesn't want you playing in his sandbox.
I'll make a note to be scared. Come on, will you? What can he do about it?
Oh, why don't you meet with him and find out?
Why don't I find out and then meet with him?
Henry is not a man you stonewall. Not Henry Kravis, not KKR.
You're going to need to raise a lot of money, Peter.
What does that mean?
Henry could be very helpful.
I'm not even in the water yet, and you're calling for a lifeboat?
You're going to have to meet with him, Peter. At worst, it's simply good politics. Linda?
Ross is up from Atlanta. My guess is he flew up under his own steam. See you later, Jim.
Why the hell does anyone have to meet with him at all?
Jim thinks it's best, and so do I.
Why? What does any of this have to do with Henry Kravis?
A million people talked to me about doing an LBO, so he was the first. Am I supposed to send Thomas Edison 2 cents every time I turn a light on?
I just don't understand the purpose of meeting with him, that's all. I mean, Henry Kravis isn't a pope, for Christ's sake, or did he buy up all the shares in the Vatican, too?
We have to gauge his intentions, see if he's going to stay out of it, or if there's some way he can be a part of this that can be to our mutual advantage.
Then I'm the one to talk to
him. Better for Peter to do it. He and Henry speak the same language.
Hell, I speak bullshit. I picked it up my first day in New York.
Ross, trust me.
Oi, Henry. George?
Peter? I'm trying to stay alive till my kids graduate.
You mind?
Aren't they really better after dinner?
I'd be very surprised if you ended up buying RJR Nabisco at 75, Peter.
Why is that?
We've been looking at this company for a long time. 75 is cheap. Very cheap.
It's what Ross wants. We're just setting up the financing for him.
And what's Shearson getting out of it?
A normal payoff, nothing special.
What does that mean? 5, 10, 15, 30% of the company, what?
In that range.
And what's Johnson's deal? Also somewhere between 0 and 100%? How much of the company will he own?
Obviously, those figures are confidential.
We have to be in on this, Peter. You understand? I didn't give this idea to Johnson just so he could send me an up yours card.
Maybe there's some way we can work this out.
Work it out how?
Well, there are a couple of options. We can compete. That would drive the price up and make the debt so high, nobody could afford to win.
Or you could sell as Ross's food business. Take tobacco for yourself.
We're not looking for partners.
Well, in that case, you could just step aside.
What, are you kidding me? You want us to step aside after all we've done on this?
Oh, we'd honor that, of course. We'd pay you a fee for your services to date, say, $125 million, plus an option to buy a 10% stake in the company.
Are you serious? I don't believe this. You're offering me a fucking bribe?
That's an offensive word, Peter. Offensive and untrue.
You're offering me $125 million to take a cab, and I'm offensive?
We're just offering a variety of options, Peter.
Well, you can stick that one up a variety of asses, okay? And stop trying to good cop, bad cop me into the ground here.
Look, one way or another, we're in on this, Peter. We're not just going to disappear. You just decide whichever way you think is best and get back to us.
Right, yeah. I'll do that.
Before the board accepts your bid, of course.
As soon as I can.
Love home, Peter.
You too, George. Jim, if we get a quick answer from the board, we'll be all right. We're just too many jumps ahead of them.
Our move. What do you think?
Napalm.
It's Ross. It just came over the wire. Henry's made a tender offer to buy RJR Nabisco.
Damn. How much?
$90 a share.
90? 90?
$20 billion.
Jesus.
Goodness.
Well, somebody pissed somebody off. I don't know what happened in that meeting, Jim, but somebody put their finger up somebody's ass or Kravis wouldn't be dropping this bomb on us. Peter Cohen just sticks to raising money from now on. Is that understood? First the press release, now this goddamn Kravis offer. Do you know how much more this deal is going to cost now? Do you have any idea how crazy the stock is going
to
go?
I want you to sell enough of my IBM to give me enough bread to buy 1,000 shares of... That's right, 1,000 shares of RJR
Nabisco.
Hey, pal. Move along, please.
Now... anybody makes a tender offer, which is like what KKR just did. And the company that's for sale has to answer it within 10 days. That's what the law says. Which means Mr. Johnson's bid is kind of like on hold because someone else has stuck their foot in the door. Now, Mr. Johnson has to top what KKR's come up with. Plus which, of course, and they could turn around and top Mr. Johnson all over again. Your husband's got one fight on his hands. What can I tell you?
It's the first and last time I have to say this. Of course the vice president's questioning my paper.
Honey?
I don't think there's any question about that.
Lace me up.
And I resent
how do I look?
Good enough to eat. We're late already.
You also have to take the man seriously.
Not too much?
Administration.
You'd get stares tonight wearing a gunny sack. We're just not members of the club, babe. You haven't had your face tightened or any basketballs removed from your hips, and I'm not part of this uptown daisy chain that never stops wheeling and dealing and screwing each other over.
But they all like you.
They've got an erection for my cookies and my cigarettes. They're just being nice to the driver. Anybody in this crowd not worth nine figures, they think you're on food stamps.
Henry, you are amazing.
You didn't know that?
Who else could bid $20 billion for a company and come home whistling?
Ain't no big thing, Messi. $20 billion, just $1 billion more than 19 is all it is.
You want a little idea of what $20 billion could get you these days? How about you could retire 1% of our national debt, or you could... buy your own B-1 bomber. That'd be a first on the block, right? Yeah. Well, I guess if you were really a sport, you could also buy each of the homeless, as well as every single person on the planet, a Big Mac, an order of fries, and a Coke. You could buy 80 million vowels on Wheel of Fortune. Or, this would be only a start, of course, You could send Dan Quayle, the University of Indiana Law School, for 6.8 million years.
You made today, Henry?
Darling, this is Ross Johnson. He came to dinner some time ago.
My wife?
Laurie.
Darling, that was the name of our first jumper.
A jumper's a horse, isn't it?
Get the picture?
What you been up to, neighbor? Word's out you've been poking around for a little action.
Just trying to keep you honest, Jim.
Now heads up to the middle and back. Face the corner. Left alley, left alley.
I think it'd be a good idea if you and I had a talk, Henry.
You know where to find me, Ross.
When you get her back home, make your mind. Dance up to the middle and then swing the opposite. Two times around, ring and go.
Henry?
Yeah?
Weave in and out around the go. There was no need to escalate things by making that offer, you know. You never gave me a chance to get back to you. I said I was going to call, and I would have.
One of us better cut in. All we need is for Peter to throw some fresh shit on the fan.
I believe in a person who does whatever he says he's going to do.
That makes two of us, doesn't it?
Ross, Teddy Forsman, Forsman Little.
Well, nice to see you. My wife, Laura.
Great pleasure. It's Tiffany Ford.
Well, howdy, ma'am. Must be the new school marm.
You know, I'd love to talk to you, Ross. Any chance of our getting together?
I'll save you the next dance.
Well, what I wanted to talk to you about was the...
Wall Street.
Perfect. You got the hots for her, he's got the hots for you.
When you get her back home, promenade. When you hold all eight to the middle with a cowboy yell.
Babe, go get yourself some chow.
Russ, Bill Woodfield, First Boston Group.
So I think we can help you with your deal by taking advantage of certain tax loopholes you may not be aware of.
Give me a call, okay?
Ross!
Bob with a partner.
In a sec.
To Alabama left with a corner.
George? Well, if you guys could take a piss and a compliment at the same time, I'd just like to say that was a whale of an offer you came up with today. $90 a share is a great tribute to the way I've run the company.
Oh, you've done a tremendous job.
You'll understand if I don't shake your hand right now.
I don't know what happened between you guys and Peter Cohen, but from now on, I do all the talking.
Seems to me you and I did talk once, Ross. At least I remember our conversation. Every word of it.
Look, Henry, no matter where the idea came from, the last thing I'm looking for right now is a bidding war. So why don't we sit down and try to hold this to a mere $20 billion deal? What do you say?
Makes a whole lot of sense, Ross.
We can figure out how to be on the same side. All I need to know about is you guys aren't going to get on my back about cutting down on planes and golf courses and all that other chicken shit stuff.
That's not what's important to us. We don't mind about an extra plane ride or two.
Just space shuttles are out, right?
They might be a lot cheaper. What's IGR up to now? 10 corporate jets, 26 full-time pilots. Where does that hangar you built in Atlanta cost your stockholders $12 million?
Those stockholders have a management group that brings in a steady billion a year in profit. I see nothing wrong in giving them whatever it takes to make their job easier. Anyway, what the hell? A few million dollars are lost in the sands of time, I always say. So... do we talk or not?
Say when. We'll be there.
You got it. And let's just keep this to ourselves, okay? I sure as hell just once would like to pick up a paper without seeing any news in it.
Couldn't agree more.
This was a good talk, Lux.
I do well in toilets.
Henry Kravis was CEO of any other company in the country except his own, they'd put him in a straitjacket. They'd take him away in a rubber limo. Henry Kravis pays out these incredible sums because his money is all junk bond crap. It's phony. He's phony. He's a fucking fraud.
If you don't like him, don't beat around the bush, Teddy.
No, it's not personal. My focus is not on that goddamn megalomaniac. No, what kills me is that these quick buck artists like Kravis, they don't give a rat's ass about the companies they buy. Okay, hey, no, I've said this in the Wall Street Journal. All they want is their steady flow of these outrageous fees. They couldn't care less if they're going to throw the whole country into a depression. Let me tell you about Forstmann Little. At Forstmann Little, what you get is reality. My brother and I are real people with real money.
All right, we'll talk, all right? I got to use that.
Hey, forget KKR, forget Drexel Burnham. In the last 5 years, Forstmann Little has turned around and sold the companies we bought for up to 10 times more than we paid for them.
Okay, we'll talk.
Well, how about tomorrow?
You got it.
Okay, listen, everybody's going to try to promote you, Ross. I want to make sure you're going with the best.
You're right. Ross.
Wally McNabb, I'm with Drexel Burnham.
She eats like a bird. Did you notice that?
Caroline, yeah, I know. They all do. I think they have a weight clause in their prenuptial deals. They put on one extra ounce or a wrinkle, they get sent to the used wife lot.
Good thing you're different. Howdy, ma'am. You must be the new school marm. Thought you were going to pop the rivets on your Levi's.
You still don't understand me, do you? To me, the most important thing about a woman is her mind.
Mm-hmm.
Does she mind if I do this? Or does she mind if I do this?
Do me, cowboy. You know her one big treat every day? Caroline's, her fix, she calls it. A glass of milk and one Oreo.
Just one? We'll never get rich that way.
Rich? Henry Kravis just gave the Metropolitan Museum $10 million.
No wonder he can't afford more than one Oreo.
Harder.
Any second now.
She's his second wife.
It takes one to know one.
He must be crazy about her. He put up $3 million just so Caroline could open her own fashion house. Can you imagine?
Didn't I bring you a dozen golf balls last week?
Do you think you're going to do this buyout with him?
I don't know, babe. There's a lot of teeing up going on, but nobody's on the green.
You know what happened after he bought out the Safeway chain? Thousands of employees got laid off. Thousands. People who'd had their jobs forever. Adele, my leg waxer, one of her cousins was one of the guys who got fired. 18 years he drove a truck for them, Ross. 18 years.
It happens, babe. It happens.
He parked the truck one last time. He went home, and he shot himself. What do you know?
Now, let's all just take a beat and get real about everything, okay? The scenario that makes the most sense is for us to join forces and fall in with Henry Kravis. That way, the board only has to consider a $90 share, which we all know they'd snap up in a second. If we try to outbid each other, no matter who wins, the company will be impossible to manage because the debt load will just be crushing. Do you have a problem with that, Peter?
You're the boss, but if we need a higher bid, I can restructure the financing. There's other money around. Henry's not the only one with resources in this town.
Is this your business sense talking, Peter, or am I getting an earful of your ego?
Listen, Ross, I don't mind insults.
Just hold it. Yeah.
Mr. Forstmann is here to see you.
Now? Give him a room. Ask him to wait.
I can hold my own with the best of them, but nobody ever asked me to take a bribe before.
Oh, Kravis was not asking you to take a bribe. That is not his style. What you're really saying is you just can't be partners with him. Isn't that it?
There's no such thing as being partners with Henry.
We will do business with whoever you say, Ross. Now, if you want us to take his offer to step aside, all you got to do is say the word. Am I right, Peter?
Ed, I think you and I should have a little powwow. You guys can stay here, use the can, whatever. Just give us a minute. Tough call.
Not the way I look at it. Were you serious about letting Ross dump us?
I had to give him the option, Peter. I'm counting on his knowing where his best interests lie.
I say you go home with the guy who brung you. I say we win with Shearson, or we go out with Shearson. Kravis will eat you alive if you let him in, you know that.
Not if I could sell him on letting me keep control of the company.
I just can't see you throwing in with him.
Let's face it, Ed. KKR is a varsity operation. Our team's been running around like a bunch of water boys with a leaky bucket. Oh, Christ, Teddy Forstman. Yes, Jill?
Mr. Kravis and Mr. Roberts are at reception, and Mr. Hugel's on line one.
Mr. Horrigan will take Kravis and Roberts to the conference room. Ask Mr. Hugel if I can... No, wait. Okay, I'll talk to him. Hold it. Ed, don't let Kravis get anywhere near Forstman. I don't need blood on the carpets. Charlie, what's on your mind, pal?
It's a matter of some importance, Ross. A good deal of importance, I would say.
When do you leave town?
Tomorrow afternoon.
Buy me breakfast tomorrow? Jesus.
Oof. You'd like to come this way?
Let's go in here.
Where did anybody put Teddy before? Jill?
George.
Jim.
Ross thinks we should all talk.
Sure glad you guys don't make cigars.
Smoke bothers you?
Only if I'm in the same city with it.
Fucking beautiful.
How you doing, Ross? Bill Woodfield, First Boston.
I'll be back. Oh, Teddy, I'm sorry.
It's okay. No problem. Ross, this is my brother, Nick.
How are you?
Great pleasure.
Now, we've worked up some ideas for financing based on, like I told you, real money with real people and not the kind of phony crap
Teddy.
This wampum,
Teddy,
this funny
Teddy,
money.
I got a level with you. I'm meeting with Henry Kravis.
See, I think it would be a huge mistake if you did that, Ross.
Well, there's no if I'm going to do it. I'm doing it. He's in the office right now.
Now? You're meeting with Kravis now? That's why we've been sitting around waiting, killing time, choking on those new shit cigarettes?
Where did you get a premiere?
There was some in the other office.
Nobody's supposed to smoke those.
I don't think that'll be a problem.
They're still in development.
I sure as hell hope so.
Look, could you guys please just wait a little while? This thing with Henry might not work out at all.
Ross, don't you see this is our last chance? The bastards are at the city gates. Let's stand at the bridge together. Let's stand at the bridge and push the barbarians back.
Right. Just give me a minute. Henry, thank you for coming.
Ross.
George.
Ross.
Hope you don't mind meeting in a conference room. All the men's johns are full. Now, the way I see it, we're down to keep it simple time. What really makes the most sense all the way around is for us to do this buyout together. At the $90 a share you guys have proposed. The way Peter structured it, my management group would own 20% of the company. Am I right, Peter?
In that area, yeah.
We'd want to review that arrangement. It seems awfully generous.
Whatever it winds up, I'm suggesting that everything else gets split 50-50 between you and Shearson.
In addition to our customary 1% for our services.
$200 million.
You might want to reconsider that amount, Henry. A lot of people are watching this process, including Congress.
Well, we certainly wouldn't want to do anything to hurt the business we've grown to love and admire.
Now, is that it, then? Basically, those terms being acceptable? Have we got ourselves a deal here?
Yes. We want Drexel Burnham to sell the bonds on this one.
Instead of Shearson?
They're what a dealer's size needs. They won't affect your share. They work cheap, and they're the best.
They're also about to go before a grand jury because of their Milk and Boesky connection.
Just what we need, stationery from Alcatraz. Maybe you ought to think about that one, Henry.
We have thought about it, Ross. With or without you, we're going for this company. We're going for RGR Nabisco, and Drexel's doing it for us.
Are you firm on that? Is that a deal breaker?
It is. That and one last point.
Why are we putzing around here? Johnson put this company in play. I don't need his permission
to
go for
it. Just give it a few more minutes.
Man, I tell you, if he doesn't need me, I sure as hell don't need him.
Didn't Don Kelly tell me you let him run his own company?
And you do remember our conversation that evening.
Don runs a very tight ship. There's no extravagance there. Don's got no Air Force, no Team Nabisco that must cost the shareholders millions every
year.
We'd
require a lot more discipline. We'd have to agree on how you would run the company.
Which is French for how you'd run me.
However you want to put it.
What you're looking for is a hand puppet, Henry. If I said yes, you'd have yours up my ass all the way to your elbow.
And there's no way the banks are going to let Drexel in either.
Everybody's firm on this?
That's it. We'll make our own bid. Now let's get out of here before I throw up from being in the same building as Kravis.
Smoke. Prick probably hates cookies, too. Fuck them. They'll get theirs one day.
Hold the door.
Probably a lot sooner than you think.
I just want my position as chairman of the company completely clear, boss. Obviously, you're going to have to go higher than 90 a share, and so is Henry Kravis. The highest bid is going to win, Ross.
Let's just put the price of shares aside for a minute, okay? Let's just screw all that. You know, the only number that means anything at all to me, 140,000. You know what that is, Charlie? That's the exact number of people who bake and pack and ship and truck for us. And the more this company winds up costing, whoever winds up buying it, the more those people are going to get the axe. That's all that's on my mind right now. Not in this macho bullshit that's got everybody slamming their dicks on the table. All I care about is making a killing for our shareholders without killing any of the people who punch in for us day after day, year after year. People who think of this company as a home.
Go your best shot, then. I'm announcing that final offers must be submitted by 5 p.m. at the next board meeting, 11 days from now.
I'll be ready. Ready for bear.
I never thought you'd be anything less.
Nothing.
Poor darling, I wish I could cheer you up. Pity we're not in the country, you could go out and shoot something.
They're absolutely stonewalling us, you know. There's no way for George and me to arrive at a realistic offer for the company without knowing its true value. And the law says Johnson's people have to cooperate with would-be buyers. Have to tell us all they know about the company's assets, about their liabilities, where it's healthy, where it's not. Now, whether it's out of fear or loyalty or acting on Johnson's orders, I don't know, but not one of them will tell us a thing. We've got less than a week to make an offer. We're flying totally blind.
Do you honest and truly need Nabisco, Henry? Aren't there any other companies that'd make you just as happy?
It's not the company. It's the credibility. My credibility. I can't just sit on the bench and let other people play the game. Not my game. Not with their rules.
So, Coach, what are you gonna do?
I don't know. I just don't know. Yeah? George. You're not serious.
We've got ourselves a deep throat. He knows where all the numbers and the bodies are buried. He wants to talk to us, Henry. He wants to be our friend. Wait a minute. Hold it. Quick, put on Channel 4.
They're called smokeless cigarettes, and they're about to come on the market, but they've already come under a sharp attack. Today, three health groups said they should be classed not as cigarettes, but as a drug, subject to regulation by the Food and Drug Administration. NBC's Mike Jensen has sampled the reaction to them.
Nothing. Nothing. Zero. It's like smoking blackboard chalk.
Brilliant. Delightful.
Wow. Newspaper.
Another first for American technology. No wonder the Japanese are trembling.
Jesus. Just what I need right now. Total strangers sticking pins in the Ross Johnson dolls, and in prime time.
Are they as bad as they said?
Premiers, I'll level with you. When they were being tested, some people suggested we roll them in toilet paper. Millions of dollars to develop, all those zeros right down the crapper.
You're entitled. God, year in, year out, that's the kind of money he makes for the company.
People take winning for granted, sweetheart. You lose a few bucks for them, they start looking at you like a virgin at an Aztec sacrifice. Premieres. Perfect name, I thought. Titanics would have been a better one. Who the hell do you suppose got NBC to do that story?
Some people are always looking for bad news, Ross.
Who told them premieres were bad news? Jesus, what a town. If you didn't have such tall buildings around here, you'd be up your ass in vultures.
Ross, Peter would like us to try to raise our bid to $110 a share.
Is that remotely feasible?
Well, he thinks so. I mean, he's sure that Henry could never go that high. He's got such little information to go by.
Breaks your heart for poor Henry, doesn't it?
110 means we'll have to raise substantially more money from the investors and the banks. It would help tremendously if you'd cut back on your share, Ross. I mean, it would help tremendously.
Is Shearson going to cut back, too? Are you guys going to take less?
Frankly, we don't have as good a deal as you have, Ross. I don't know that anybody ever has.
If your numbers were to get out, as they stand right now, you'd probably get a lot of flack about it.
Especially from your board.
Why would they ever get out?
Well, where did that premiere story come from tonight? This town worships success. What it roots for is failure. Everybody else's, of course. And I just don't think you ought to provide those types with any kind of ammunition.
Fine. Fine. Reduce my share to whatever. I don't care. Money is the last thing I'm interested in this deal. You may think I'm shitting you, but that's the truth. And fuck you, Tom.
Myself the reason why, like an answer from above, you came into my life.
Johnny stabbed me in the back. I've treated him like a son.
What better reason to do it?
Did you tell Peter? This has got to affect our bed, doesn't it?
Well, I'm meeting him in a few... Of course, no decision without you.
Ross, you know you can trust me. Driver, this traffic is impossible.
Ross, you know what? I'll call you from Peter's.
Keep me posted.
I gotta run.
I gotta get out of this town.
Ross? Darling? I think you better see this.
My entire deal with Shearson all over the goddamn paper. Now, how the hell is that possible? How could that happen? Whoever that is, I am not here.
Okay. Hello? No, he's not, operator. If you give me a number, I'll have Mr. Johnson call Mr. Hugel as soon. I'm afraid he can't be reached for a few hours. What time is Mr. Hugel's flight?
Jesus, this makes me look like the greediest son of a bitch in the world.
Is that your number, operator, or Mr. Hugel's in Moscow?
Story's probably in fucking prostitute.
Thanks.
Get me Peter Cohen.
Hello? It's Peter Cohen.
You goddamn right it is. Peter, what is our private, confidential, top secret, for your eyes only arrangement doing all over the New York fucking Times? Who leaked the goddamn thing?
I've got Jim on, Ross. We're on a conference call. Jim?
Ross?
Ross is on, Jim.
Not now, Harry.
Who the hell's Harry?
No, no, it's just me.
We're on top of this thing, Ross.
We're checking it out right now.
Can you imagine the effect of this on the board?
We hit them with our new bid. They'll forget all about it, I promise
you. Our new bid being what?
We think we can offer 112 a share.
112? Are you serious?
If we can work out all the details, we've got to prove what we're proposing makes
sense.
What
do you mean, if you can work them out? We have to make the offer tomorrow.
We can do it, Ross, can't we, Peter?
I'm sure we can. It's just the numbers are so stratospheric. We've got an awful lot of...
You know what kind of an operator this makes me look like to Charlie?
Sir, it's a Mr. Hugel.
Oh, boy.
Tell him I'll call him back. I'm talking to Ross Johnson.
What?
Nothing.
Somebody just said Ross Johnson. I heard him. Jesus, is somebody bugging my calls now? What the hell's going on?
First Tom Brokaw, now the New York Times. You don't think I'm being crucified, and Henry Kravis just might own the nail concession.
I hate to think that, Ross. My own feeling is that there are just so many people involved.
Too many fax machines.
We'll get to the bottom of it.
Everybody's got a fucking Xerox.
How do I face Charlie Hugel tomorrow about all this rotten press?
We'll get to the bottom of it all.
I'm at the bottom of it all. I'm standing in a shitstorm, and nobody on this team has got a goddamn umbrella.
We'll be right back.
put us in a terrible position, Ross. The board hasn't stopped calling me. You've made us look like fools for not knowing about this agreement. Even bigger fools if we did.
Charlie.
$2.5 billion for your management group. That's what your 20% share of the company stands to earn for you in the next 5 years. $2.5 billion. Ross, that boggles the mind.
Charlie, those are purely hypothetical numbers, blown way the hell out of all proportion. But if they stick in somebody's craw, fine. Fuck them. Forget them. I'll just take whatever the board thinks I'm worth. Hell, Charlie. All I am is a salesman. You know that. I've been one door-to-door, house-to-house, company-to-company all my life. A salesman's biggest commission isn't measured in bucks. Every sale we poor bastards ring up is a validation of who we are. People buy you when they buy what you're selling. There's just one hitch. A salesman needs product, Charlie, product. I'm not looking to buy this company because my business is buying companies. I need this company to make things and wrap them in shiny packages. I'm not one of this bunch that only cares about buying up places where things get made. Charlie, this crazy deal heat everywhere is burning all our bridges. We're piling up mountains and mountains of debt. We're borrowing our damn fool brains out. And just because we have gone crazy doesn't mean the rest of the world has. This country is turning companies into commodities, and the Japanese have got their fetuses working nights churning out computer chips.
Final bids are due in the boardroom at 5 o'clock. Not 1 minute later.
However it turns out, your opinion of me means an awful lot in my life, Charlie.
We're down to the numbers now, Ross. That's all that matters now. Now I know what the F in F. Ross Johnson stands for.
Juanita, nice to
Ross.
See you. Hello, Barry.
You can't take any more time, Rob.
Trouble City. Charlie's pissed. The whole board.
I don't care. You've got to get it the hell over here.
What's wrong?
Peter's office is still futzing around with our numbers.
What?
There are a million details, Ross.
They're still at your office.
They're just leaving.
Jesus, that's all
don't
the way downtown. I got a whole boardroom full of people here today. Just love me to
I
be
don't
a half
care.
Second
what?
Late. Give me that. Rob.
We're doing our best, Ross.
Get over here right now. Do you hear me? Whatever you got to do, do it on the way. Do it in the goddamn cab.
Oh, on a Friday at this hour.
Yes,
good
in
luck.
The cab.
Tell him to take the drive.
How are you doing? Where are you? 14th and where?
14th and the river.
It's just... traffic's brutal.
Maybe we should get off the drive.
How you do that?
They're at 39th and 1st.
15 minutes.
Fifty-third.
We're boxed in completely.
Are you serious?
Go! Go on, I'm telling you, go!
Okay, Ross. We're on our way.
Never. Crap.
Oh, shit. Move, Rob, move!
Very good.
Expect an answer.
Thank you.
Talk to you later.
One minute, two.
Where is he?
Rob, where are you? Rob?
Our luck has been mugged.
Rob?
We're in the elevator.
What floor?
Hold on. Just one second.
Rob?
Where is he?
I don't know.
Now, first off, I'd like you to know that in the interest of the company, I have retained the services of Peter Atkins of the firm of Skadden Arps to act as special counsel to advise us and guide us through the legal obligations of this matter. Peter?
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Good afternoon. Before you are copies of the proposals for the buyout of RJR Nabisco.
And where do we stand?
Ross Johnson's bid, his and Shearson's, is for $100 a share. That's an offer of $23 billion.
And KKR?
$94 a share. $21.6 billion.
That's quite a difference in price.
I'll give you a bigger one. The First Boston Group is prepared to offer between 105 and 118. That's $3 billion more than the Johnson offer.
Is First Boston for real?
Well, their proposal is based on taking advantage of certain tax loopholes. If the board has any interest, we'll need some expert advice as to the viability of it all. It would take a week to 10 days.
I'd say the board has about $26 billion worth of interest in waiting.
It's an air ball, Henry. There's no way in the world First Boston can pull it off. No way at all. We're still alive, I promise you.
Second place is no better than third.
All we have to do is lay low. We put out the word, we don't know what we're gonna do. Let's let the world know. We may not be there in 10 days. Then if we do back off, we save ourselves the embarrassment. If we're coming back strong in the second round, why let on?
Either way, no one sees our hand.
Let them curse the darkness. We're not handing out any candles.
What makes you think Peter can go any higher than we have? Jesus, Jim, these numbers are giving me a nosebleed already. Hold on. Yes, I'll take it. It's Linda. She says it's important. Linda?
Ross, are you ready for this? Henry has gone to his place in Vail.
Do I like that?
He and Caroline are spending the week there skiing. George has gone home to San Francisco. It all ties in.
Ties into what?
Well, the word is, having come in third, there's a strong chance that Henry might not bid next time around.
You believe that? You think it's really possible?
All I know is that Henry finishes first or he doesn't finish at all. Going away like he has? I mean, skiing in the middle of all this?
Did you see it? They threw in the towel. I told you they would.
Don't bet on it.
Why would they put out a press release saying they're not going to be back for the next round?
Why would they say one thing and do another? Why the hell wouldn't they?
Well, what do you hear? Are they coming back or aren't they?
All I know is what Linda tells me, and she's pretty sure they're out.
Yes, yes, I'm up. What do you think I'm thinking about?
I'm telling you, we play right into their hands if we don't raise our bid. They're laying low so they can come in and clobber us. This is just a head fake. It's a PR job.
Well, if it is, it certainly is a masterful one.
I don't mind those once in a while, do you? Just for a change.
Well, you should have gotten away yourself. We've been on the slopes 8 hours a day.
Well, some of us still have to work for a living, Henry. All of us thought you'd be back here crunching numbers like the rest of us.
You crunch numbers, I'll crunch the snow. Let me put Caroline on. I promised myself I wouldn't think about business all week.
You're sure?
Oh, yes, I'm positive. Now, he's out of it. Even Caroline thinks so.
Trust me, Ross. Kravis is going to be there. He's going to bid.
Well, I don't know one thing more than you do. You know that.
Well, let me tell you, figuring whether they're in or out is an absolute son of a bitch. Do me one favor, John. Don't wish me luck.
I want to thank you all for your patience during this 10-day interval. It was obviously a step that had to be taken.
Now, that said, I'll turn the meeting over to Peter Atkins.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. To begin, let me tell you that we're now down to two bidders. After a good deal of effort, First Boston was simply not able to put their offer on the table. That leaves us with Ross Johnson. His groups bumped their previous bid from $100 a share to $101. I think we need to take a very careful look at what KKR has offered.
What do you think?
I think it's going to be a long day. A very long day.
I've been sent to ask you a question. Is what you've submitted your very best offer?
Yes.
The very best you can do?
It is.
Well, if we can work out some of the details and get comfortable with regard to the financing, I'm prepared to recommend your bid to the board. If you'll just give us a little time, an hour should do it.
Peter, I've got a pile of people wondering when there's going to be a decision.
I'd say there's no reason to hang around. We'll be in touch with you tomorrow.
What are you saying tomorrow? What does that mean?
Look, I can't tell you anymore.
Peter, are we out of it?
I've said all I can say.
Charlie, what the hell's going on? I'm still CEO of this company, you know. I mean, we haven't got a new pope around here yet. Or have we?
Oh, this is most unusual, Ross. All right, 5 minutes. I'll meet you there.
I understand my people have been told to go home. Care to embellish that
First
a little?
First Boston is out of it. KKR has made a bid.
Another bid? A new one? Higher than mine?
Frankly, it's a blockbuster.
Are we talking the neighborhood of $5 higher than mine? Are we talking 106?
You said it, Ross. I didn't.
Skiing my ass. Henry Kravis is skiing down Mount Bullshit. He sandbagged us.
I know it. You said...
He was trying too hard to sell me.
You assured he was out of it.
We're the only ones that are going to be out of it unless we get off our cans. Peter, whip out your calculator.
What the hell is going on? They told us hours ago they were going to recommend us to the board. We had a deal. Everything was fine.
Shearson's bid, 108. Did they come in with that bid, or did they find out about ours? We've got to do what's best for the shareholders, George. Which includes asking you not to leave. We want you in this. Now, you've been more than patient. Give us an hour to go over it all.
We are not interested in open-end bidding.
Just 1 hour.
All right. You pay our expenses to date, and we'll wait.
How much are we talking about?
I would say it comes to a hell of a lot more, but we'll settle for $45 million.
$45 million for 1 hour. I think I can sell it. Thank you, Henry.
Ross Johnson's final bid, his final bid, is for $112 a share. The KKR bid is $109.
Thank you, Peter. I think it's time to put it to a vote.
Ay, Dios mío. Oh, I'm sorry, Mr. Johnson. We'll do your office after the ballroom. They shouldn't be too long now. They were just getting ready to vote. Good luck.
Thanks.
They're voting.
Yeah. Yeah. Right. I'm on my way. Charlie wants to see me.
Both offers were based on extremely complicated structures. We had to consider very carefully just how sound they really were. In the end, I'd say the deciding factor, the one thing that made the Kravis offer more attractive, was the fact that you were not part of it. Nobody's going to deny that there's not a fair amount of greed going around these days. I guess it's just a question of how much greed is fair. This, yours, was over the top. It was simply too naked. There was just no way we could let you have this company, Ross.
I lost my job through the New York Times, is that it?
We'll be discussing your settlement as soon as possible.
It's the first time I've been out of work since I was 9 years old. Sure loved running this company, Charlie. Let you in on a little secret. I'd have paid you to let me do it.
Thanks, Charlie. We'll be right in.
I just dropped by to say thank you. You know, for making me a hero with my shareholders. $25.7 billion for the company. In their wettest dreams, they never thought they'd get that rich. If there's anything I could do to help, anything you need.
That's very generous, Ross.
Yes, well, we don't take over till after the first of the year. We don't have any plans as yet.
Well, just holler. Congratulations. You guys bought yourselves one hell of a company. I really hate to leave on a sour note, but about that $25 billion, if you're planning on signing for it, Jim Robinson just canceled your American Express card.
How the hell do you win a company like ours playing lowball? Does somebody want to tell me that?
I've never heard of the highest bid ever losing before.
I say we were fucked. I say we sue their asses off.
You and Laura got anything on tonight?
I think maybe it'll just be the two of us.
Four is twice the company.
Fucked!
You know, Jim, if I hadn't married Laurie...
Fucked, without a doubt.
I'd have probably married old Ed here. Take care, guys.
See you, Ross.
Peter.
Ross.
Adjustments to make, he's got his.